Morning, children. Welcome to our maths class. It is the class for standard 9 who study the syllabus of ICSC. Students, today we will discuss about the rational and irrational number. In previous classes, I taught these things, the number system. In number system, you have to study the rational and irrational number. So, classified form of the rational and the irrational number, we will study about these two terms. So, rational number, according to the definition, a number is in the form of P by Q, and where Q is not equals to 0, P and Q also belongs to the integral number. In previous number system, I taught you these things, rational number having the terms of integral number. So all the integral numbers also the rational number. So when you are writing the term P by Q, that means in form of numerator and denominator, so you can write 2 by 1, 3, 4, 5 by 7, 0. 0 it means 0 by 1 is also the rational number. But when you are writing 2 by 0, here it is given, Q is not equals to 0. So when you are writing 2 by 0, so it is not the rational number. Similarly, a number in the form of P by Q, where Q is equals to 0. So, and Q and P and Q also belongs to the integral number. So it is called the irrational number. Just like example, root 2. Root 2 is an irrational number, root 3, root 5, root 6, etc. But when you are writing the root 4 is equals to 2, which gives the perfect number. So it is not the irrational number. It is the part of the rational number. So you can write root 4 also equals to 2. So when you are getting the square root of any number, that is called the rational number, and you are not finding the square, perfect square number, that's why it is called the irrational number. Next term, the rational number is in the form of recurring decimal or repeating decimal. So when you are writing the rational number 1 by 3, so it is equals to 0.33333 up to show on. So you can also give the recurring, that is 0, 3 to the power recurring. Or somewhere it is also written like this, recurring. So rational number is always in the form, rational number in the form of recurring decimal number or the repeating decimal number. But when you are writing 2.12343317 up to so on, what you find? This number is irrational number because it is not repeating like this. 333, here it is 1234321317, it is repeated, but not the same number is repeated. Numbers are repeated, but not repeated the same number like this. That's why it is called the non-repeating or non-recurring decimal number. It is more clearly, irrational number is non-terminating and non-repeating decimal or non-recurring decimal number. Like this, when you are writing this form of number, you are getting like this 3.142151 up to show on. It is non-terminating and non-recurring. You are not giving the hyphen like this. So it is an irrational number. Irrational number always be in the form of non-terminating and non-repeating decimal. Here it is, terminating decimal number. Terminating decimal number, the number whose fraction in the form of, fraction whose denominators are the factor of only 2, only 5, only 2 and 5 both are called the terminating decimal number. So terminating decimal number is the part of a rational number. Like this, when you are writing 4 by 5, when you are cancelling it, it becomes 0.8. 2 by 5, it is also equals to 0.4. 4 by 10, so it is 4 into factor of 2 and 5, so it is the terminating and is also equals to 0.4. So whenever you have to study the terminating and non-terminating, only the denominators are the factor of 2, only 5, or 2 and 5. Clear? So terminating decimal you can find without actual division. There is no need to divide the terms to find the terminating and non-terminating, only by the factor of 2, factor of 5, or factor of 2 and 5 will decide the terminating and non-terminating decimal number. In next video, I will talk to you, I will discuss about the problems.